TV. Today I will be showing you an introduction to servo motor control. All servo motors have built-in feedback devices that checks for errors and negative feedback, which then can correct the motor's performance. This is a closed-loop system, but due to the response to error control, it can allow for greater precision when compared to AC induction motors. The servo motors are also thinner and have lower inertia, which allows for extremely fast forwarding and reverse switching. This type of motor is usually hooked up to a servo amplifier that feeds the PWM signal. Servo control uses a series of set points and the indexes for the direction the motor will need to go and the position the application is needed to be in. When more than one motor is used, the motors can be controlled independently or synchronized, allowing for an application to be controlled on the X and Y axis. By providing set points, the motors will use the feedback device to ensure synchronization. This could be used in a CNC or laser cutter that requires circular interpolation. Additional servo motors can be used to move an application side to side, front to back, up and down, and also diagonally. There are two methods of controlling the position of an application through a servo amplifier. The first is speed. An analog voltage input is given to adjust the speed reference and will use full torque to get to the position set in the index. The speed can be adjusted by an external controller. The other method of controlling through a servo amplifier is through torque. The torque is also controlled by an analog voltage input and can be set in a way that the application will use the amount of torque required to get to the desired set point. An example of this in action is where a machine is fastening an object that requires a certain level of torque. After the proper level of torque is applied, the system can check to see if the fastener is in the correct position. If the fastener is not in the correct position, the system will indicate a bad unit and adjust accordingly. If speed control was used in place of torque control, the system would apply excessive force and ignore the potential hazard that caused the stop before, resulting in damage to the unit. External controllers can be used to ensure that both speed and torque can be controlled in conjunction with each other. This can allow for the unit to reduce speed when approaching the set point and use the appropriate force that is required. Servo motors can also be linked together so that they work in sync, such as in electronic gearing and camming. Servo amplifiers and motors, along with thousands of other products and services, are available at galco.com.